Hello friends, today we are going to start with a very important chapter of quantitative aptitude, that is speed and distance, one of chapters having the highest weightage in your competitive exam. So this chapter we are going to see and we will discuss the basics of this chapter now. So from the formulas to the advanced level question, all we are going to see. Okay, so we will start now. Walking at a speed of how much? 4 km per hour. Men cover a certain distance in 3 hours 45 minutes. So this is a question that is similar to your plain one. As I told you that examiner can make 1000 type of question, but you need to understand the concepts. Once you understand the concept, everything become very simple. So what is the time? Time is 3 hours and 45 minutes. So this 45 minutes need to be converted in hours. So how you will convert this 3 hour plus 45 minutes? You can write as 45 by, in 1 hour how many minutes are there? 60. So this get cancelled out. This comes out to be 3 by 4. So when you solve this, the time in hour will be 15 by 4 hour. Right? So this will be 15 by 4 hour. You have speed, you have time. Now you can find the distance. Your formula is speed equal to distance upon time. You have time, you have speed. Now you can find the distance. So you can do that. So 4 into 15 by 4. So this 4, 4 get cancelled and you will get the distance, which is 15 km is the distance that the person covered, right? And now cycling at a rate of 16.5 km per hour. Now you have new speed, right? And it is asked that at what time he will cover the same distance. The same distance means he have to cover 15 km distance. And now the speed is changed to 16.5 km per hour. You have speed, that is 16.5 km per hour. You can convert it. You can write it as 33 by 2. 16.5 you can write in this manner. So you can solve it. Now your formula is speed equal to distance upon time. You have distance, you have speed, you can find out time. So time equal to 15 upon 33 by 2. So this 2 will go in numerator, time equal to 30 by 33. So when you solve this 30 by 33, it comes out to be 0.90 something. Okay. So now this is in hours, but the time is asked in minute. So you have to convert it in minute. In 1 hour, how many minutes are there? 60 minutes. So you have to multiply this 0.90 with 60 in order to convert it in minutes. So now the thing will come in minutes. So this will comes out to be 54.54. This is the answer. Okay. This is the answer. So this how you need to find the answer. Okay, now here is a question. A train covers a distance of 10 km in 12 minutes. If its speed is decreased by 5 km per hour, the time taken by it to cover the same distance is. So distance, you know, time, you know, but time is in minutes. So you have to convert it in hours. So 12 minutes, you have to convert it in hours. So in 1 hour, how many minutes are there? 60. This comes out to be 1 by 5 hour. So you have 10 km. So your speed equal to distance upon time. So you know the distance, that is 10. You know the time, that is 1 by 5. So this go in numerator, but the earlier speed is 50 km per hour, right? Now it is told to you that the speed is decreased by 5 km per hour. So what will be the new speed? You decrease 5 km per hour with the old speed, then new speed is 45 km per hour. And what is the time required to cover the same distance? What is the distance? Distance is 10 km. Now the time is changed. Now time is in the speed is in kilometer per hour. The distance is in kilometer, but the time is asked in minutes. So we can convert it later. Okay. So your formula is speed equal to distance upon time. You know the speed, that is 45 km per hour. You know the distance, that is 10 km. Now you can find out the time. The earlier speed is 50 km per hour, right? Now it is told to you that the speed is decreased by 5 km per hour. So what will be the new speed? you decrease 5 km per hour with the old speed, then new speed is 45 km per hour. And what is the time required to cover the same distance? What is the distance? Distance is 10 km. Now the time is changed. The speed is in kilometer per hour. The distance is in kilometer, but the time is asked in minutes. So we can convert it later. Okay. So your formula is speed equal to distance upon time. You know the speed, that is 45 km per hour. You know the distance, that is 10 km. Now you can find out the time. Time equal to 10 km you have to cover. And now the new speed is 45 km per hour. This will cut. This comes out to be 2/9. 2/9 hours. So hours you have to convert it in minute. So for converting it in minute, with what number you will multiply it? 60. Right? 60. So if you multiply it by 60, so 2 into 60, it comes out to be 120 divided by 9. It comes out to be 33.33. Okay, 33.33. Now 33.33, what that means? It means one third part of a minute, one third part of a minute. So 1 minute, if there is 60 seconds, so what will be one third? One third will be 20 seconds, right? 20 seconds. Similarly, if I tell you 1/6 of a minute, so in 1 minute, you know how many seconds are there? 60 seconds divided by 6, that means 10 seconds, right? So this how you have to make the time, or you have to calculate the seconds, right? If it comes out to be 33.25, so you must know that 25 means 1/4, 1/4, right? 1/4 of 1 minute. So 1 minute consists of 60 seconds. So you will convert it. Likewise, whatever the answer that will come, it will come 15. So 13.15. So this is how you have to convert the after point, whatever the fraction come, you can convert it in this manner. Next, let's move to the next question. Okay, now this is a concept of average speed. Okay, a car driver leaves Bangalore at 8:30 a.m. and expect to reach 300 km from Bangalore at 12:30 p.m. At 10:30 p.m., he finds that he only covers 40% of the distance. By how much he has to increase the speed to cover the remaining in order to reach the scheduled time? Okay, so there is 300 km, right? So what is the 40% of 300 km? 40% is 120 km, right? How you calculate 300 into 40/100? When you do this, it comes out to be 120 km. So 120 km distance he covered till what time? 10:30 a.m. right? So how much is remaining now? 180 km is remaining. He need to cover 180 km, and in what time he has to cover? 10:30 to 12:30 p.m. means he has 2 hour time. He has 2 hours time that is left with him, and he have to cover 180 km. Now you know the formula is speed equal to distance upon time. You know the distance, you know the time. Now you can find out the speed. Now you can find out the speed, right? 180 km he have to cover. 180 km he have to cover, and in 2 hours he have to cover. So this comes out to be 90 km per hour. So the right answer is 90 km. I guess while typing, person did the mistake. The answer is 90 km per hour. Okay, now this type of question is similar to the one which I did earlier, right? So a student goes to school at a speed of 5/2 km per hour and reaches 6 minutes late. If he travels at a speed of 3 km per hour, he reaches 10 minutes earlier. The distance of the school is. So what you have to do is, you have to first assume clock, right? This is a clock. Suppose you are traveling with certain speed, you get late by 6 minutes, right? 6 minutes late mean at what time you are arriving? 12:06. And next day you increase your speed and you reach 10 minutes early. So 10 minutes earlier with the scheduled time, that is 12 p.m. At what time you are reaching? 11:50. What is the difference between the entire time? 16 minutes, right? 16 minutes. Now this is given in kilometer per hour. This is given in kilometer per hour, second speed. and the time is in minutes, so we can convert it. What I told you, x is the distance that they have to cover. You don't know the distance, right? What is the speed? 5/2 km/h, right? Minus x is the distance that he have to cover. What is the speed now? 3 km/h. The difference between their speed is how many minutes? 16 minutes. So it is in minutes, but you have to convert it in hours. So divide by 60. This you can cut, right? This you can cut by 4. So it comes out to be 4 and below 15. 4/15. So now you can solve this. This go into numerator 2x/5 minus x/3. This comes out to be 6x minus 5x upon 5 × 3, that is 15. Okay, equal to 4/15. So this 15 get cancelled. This 6x minus 5x equal to x equal to 4 km. So the distance between school is from home to school is 4 km. So this is how you need to calculate. Simple, it is very simple. Just you need to understand the concept. I never told you many formulas, or I never make you remember those formulas. I just told you a simple formula: speed equal to distance upon time. On the basis of this formula only, I'm solving all the questions. No need to mug up all hundreds of formulas. Just understand this small concept. Finish. The entire work is finished. Okay, now you can see the question. Shreya with her family travel from bus Bholpur to Surat by speed of 40 km/h and return to the Bholpur at a speed of 50 km/h. The average speed of the whole journey. I told you this concept in the beginning, when there is two different speed and first half is covered by x speed and second half is covered by another speed. So you can find what formula I told you: 2 × x / y / x + y, right? So you can solve this question with this formula. What is the speed that it is traveling? 40 km × 50 km × 2 × x + y, that is 40 + 50, that comes out to be 90. When you multiply all those, but it comes 40 × 2 × 50, this comes out to be 4000 by 90. When you do this, the answer comes out to be 44.44 km. 44.44 km. So you can solve 4/9, so it comes out to be 0.44. This is right answer, so you can go with this. Okay, thank you.